Dear chess friends, welcome to our live broadcast of the match between Ukraine and Turkey under 20 years. So I have a guest now in my transmission in the second part of this match. He is Alexander Prokhorov. Welcome, Mr. Alexander Prokhorov. I will call you Sasha.
Yes, it's okay for me. I want to say some few words in Turkish. İyi günler, sizi İgir Lamak'tan memnun oldum. It's okay, I believe.
Sizi görmekten memnun oldum, you said. Yes, okay. I am very happy to see you, you said. Okay. Thank you. I am also very happy to see you, Oleg. I cannot say it in Ukrainian. I'm really sorry. I wish I could, but I cannot say it. Sorry. First of all, before we start commenting the games, I want to tell you to our viewers that the first part of this match is finished in favor of Turkey with a very close margin, 7.5 and 6.5. What do you want to say about the first half of this match?
Yeah, I think it's well done started, so I'm really satisfied about the result, because during the game, mostly of the games, we should lose, but we try to survive in every game. Maybe you remember the last game with Semen Mitusov, and he tried to survive in the Queen's ending. But generally is okay. So the average rating of opponents is very close, and I think we are just for now we are in the middle, and okay, we have now big opportunity to win, because we play Ukraine team play with the white pieces all the second matches. But okay, it's closely, because players are mostly on the same level. So, okay, we just play in the friendly match. Just I want to mention about this, because the idea was to organize this, to give an opportunity, possibility to play for the juniors. So that's why probably the result is not important. Maybe more important is to see the games, to see their level, how they grow up during the now Corona time. So I think this is important, just to meet. And I hope that everybody of participants will meet maybe in Antalya in November 2029. Who knows, maybe it will be possibility to organize this huge European youth event.
Yes. Sasha, also, can you tell us about yourself, about what you are doing in FIDE, what is your role in FIDE? And for the moment, how is Ukraine is preparing for this? I mean, pandemic times. You know, are they working? Are they playing in online? What are they doing, players?
Mostly, we don't have any, let's say, overboard tournaments now. Maybe there are some few Blitz and Rapid. So this is a big problem, I think, also in Turkey. This also really big problem to have overboard tournaments in real life. But we have a lot of activities, let's say, in online chess. There are a lot of events on Chess.com, Lichess, also Tornello. You remember that 2020 European Chess Union organized a lot of online events, official. So a lot of players from Ukraine, especially these players who participate now, they also play. And for example, Igor Samonenkov he reached the medal. Also during the World Youth organized by FIDE, Igor also reached the medal. So I believe that they all prepare for online chess. Of course, this is not real chess. We're supposed to return back to regular life, and then they can improve more. Also, problem is with increasing rating. Yeah, I mean standard FIDE rating, because if you don't have any tournaments, but you prepare, you study in your home, you teach a lot, yeah, you learn, you play. It's not possible to go up, yeah. So of course, online ratings, it's not a criteria. But okay, I believe that for the real events, mostly of participants from Ukraine and Turkish side will be prepared. As I know, it's unofficially, there will be some events during the 2021. So that's why, as I mentioned before, we are looking forward to see what will happen in autumn. Maybe European youth will be start in this period. I hope so. About me, generally, I'm most activity in online now. During 2020, I have only two overboard events. It was one open tournament in Kyiv. It's the capital of Ukraine. With a big prize fund, it was around 5,000 euro. So for Ukraine, it's a very, very good result. For organization that they find and prepare this huge prize fund. And I have also one round robin tournament in just rating with the six players. It was also broadcasted on PlayChess and many other platforms. So for overboard tournaments, that's all for me. But mostly now I try to organize many things. I mean, online, I'm a streamer on Chess.com, on LeChess. So when I play my games, when I start to play some events, I try to broadcast, especially in Ukraine language, just to promote more Ukraine. As you know, in Ukraine, we also speak Russian. So everybody understands Russian. But I think that it's good to promote, especially Ukraine language. Also, I was arbiter during the top events, Olympiad for Disabled, World Youth, European Blitz Championship. So every top events, I was arbiter there. And also my idea is to give chance, a possibility to play for juniors. So in 2020, I managed to organize a lot of matches. It was in total, it was 11 matches with top European and world teams as Kazakhstan, Azerbaijan. We play also with Hungary, Czech Republic, Belarus, Italy, etc. So the format was maybe another. We play some Blitz matches, arena, team arena on LeChess. We play on Chess.com with rapid control, 15 plus 10. We played 3 plus 2. So different time controls, different formats. And I think there was a good preparation for European youth and world youth, which was organized in 2020. So now mostly I'm activity on this. That's why this is very nice and good idea and tradition to organize together such a friendly match between Turkey and Ukraine. So I'm very happy that we meet and we give all condition and possibility for the young players to meet each other and they can play and improve themselves.
Okay, thank you for this information. Let's now begin the commentary of the games, if you wish. On the first board, Vladislav Sidorica, a FIDE Master. What do you think about him? He is a FIDE Master with 2331 ELO.
Yes, I know Vladislav very well. Okay, during the 2019 and 2020, during the let's say regular life, he reached five medals on Ukraine champion chess championship under his age. So he was, and also he played in India 2019. It was World Youth and group under 18, he reached 15th place. Maybe you remember this event. It was top huge event. A lot of grandmasters play. I think Pranhananha won the that time, and so it was a good
very good result,
good result for Vladislav. Yeah. So he's as I mentioned, he's a pool of medalists during the 19 and 20 years.
But today, on the first game he played, incredibly bad. I don't understand
he blundered,
why.
He blundered in the opening, so it was some small tactic. Probably, I analyzed this variation maybe some few years ago. I don't remember exactly. Yeah, and it was some trick, from the white side. So if black doesn't know this variation, so it can be some trouble. But okay, it happens. It happens. Maybe Vladislav have some problems with preparation, but generally is okay. It happens. So probably in overboard game it will not happen, but you know.
As we were speaking with our with my guest, this game you mentioned, he made a mistake in the opening. Actually, the game transposed from Rogozin, and then Nimzovic, and then the Panov attack, or the Queen's Gambit accepted.
Yeah, yeah.
You start to work for Rogozin, for example, in your preparations, but the game goes to another defense, Nimzovic, and then goes to another defense, Panov. So you have to work all these systems.
Yeah, it's very hard. Yeah, but generally the pawn structure is the same as Panov, so it's more than quiet open. So it's hard for black. Yeah, so they need to make equal position, but it's really hard. So you need to make move by move and the best move. If not, so anyway, the white will take a small advantage then from the opening finish, and when they transfer to end game, it possibly in this structure can be some problems because of d5 when you exchange the queen. So it we can say a lot about this.
Let's start the games.
Start
the first board,
the board one, the second game. So
he plays g3. And this is now probably English opening.
Yeah. Yes. E6. It's a very rare move. I don't
yes,
know.
Yes, very, very unusual move. Yes.
Unusual.
Right. Yeah. Very unusual.
D5. Okay. After D4, it's possible to transfer to Grunfeld in some.
Yes, exactly.
Position.
It's like Grunfeld, and also in some lines of g3 system, the queen, king's Indian systems, we can reach this position. So maybe now it's transposition again.
Okay, the structure is the same as Karlsbad system, yeah?
Yes.
But bishop is on
but g3. There is the fianchetto.
Yeah, fianchetto.
From both sides.
Yeah, so probably white need to go before b5 after. Yes. This to, let's say, flank attack, on queen side.
Takes. Now you gave up two bishops.
It's equal position, as you see, no problems for black. Okay,
but rook e3. Why sacrifice the exchange?
Sacrifice, it's positional trick.
Yeah, but I'm not sure about this.
Me too, because now white will have d4 square.
Yeah. And also after this knight e6, he played h3, now threatens g4. This is also looks like a little bit, I don't know what to do now with black.
Okay, you need to go with knight again somewhere, maybe g7, I don't know, maybe c7. It's maybe g5, maybe you need to go g5, I don't know.
Maybe.
No, I mean the pawn g5. Okay, it's not position.
Maybe there is f4, yes.
F4, yeah, yes. It's
pawn g5, yes.
No, pawn g5. But okay, still okay. White have a problem with white squares. But when you have a bishop.
Maybe
g2,
now this is also bad. Maybe
okay.
F4, what's going on here? Maybe you take, yes.
Okay, take. Take,
maybe you can take now.
Gf4.
Maybe now somewhere.
And after you can go knight g3 just to protect.
Ah, he played, I think.
Yeah, he played. Which move?
G5.
G5, yeah, as we say.
So
yeah.
You guessed it very well.
Dynamic chess, yeah. We'll
dynamic
see.
Dynamic chess, G5. Let's go for this. G4. Let's look at the most active move. Takes days, queen somewhere. Where do you go?
I think F6 or G7.
F6,
yeah.
Okay, knight
Maybe G3. F6 is enough. Knight G3, and after white should go queen, king H2. Just to protect everything.
What black is doing now?
Okay, you need to put rook on G8. It's logic.
Maybe knight G7. Maybe I want
also to take... possible. But anyway, white will stay. They will not take on F5. Never. It's not good.
But looks like white is better. You know, I don't know. I don't see compensation for this exchange.
Yeah, maybe engine can help us. But okay, the engines mostly are material.
Yeah, usually the engines I don't use in my commentaries. When it's too complicated, sometimes I am using, but very rarely.
I prefer
not to. I mean, go so much. I mean, to the engine. Also, we have 14 matches to comment. So if you want to say. Let's say white slightly better. What do you think about this?
Yeah, I agree with you. We will see on a few moves what will happen.
Let's move on to the second board. Okay, Alexey Kukelko.
Alexey Kukelko is also well-known FIDE master and national master from Odessa. Odessa region. So he was also he reached some couple of medals during this last year. So he's well known in Ukraine, and also he played some tournaments abroad, international tournaments in Europe. Okay, so it was probably
also the same thing happened to him in the first game. He made a blunder.
The same as Vladislav, the same situation. Maybe he don't have time to prepare well, or maybe he missed some variations. Uh-huh. Okay, it's Caro Kann, H4.
Yes.
Interesting.
H4, H5, and then Bishop D3.
Yeah, I believe it's all theory. Yeah, it's a well-known.
Yes, probably. I pass this quickly, this part of the game, because if we analyze the opening, it will not be finished. The games are already rapid control. So, in the first part of this, commentary, when I went to see the game, I just look at the game, and the game already finished. One side is just checkmated.
It's too fast in rapid, especially. Also, in Blitz, it's not possible to comment. So you can only observe some few games. Let's say when I also broadcasting. Okay, queen h7. Okay, so white want to simply take on h5. It's logic.
The h5 pawn is
okay. After g6, you can simply take on f7. So I don't know what
g6 not possible because f7 is hanging after g6. So how to protect this? I don't see how.
No chance to protect. I think black need to think about how to find some dynamic here. Okay, maybe f6. F6 maybe is possible.
You want to complicate the game, yes?
Yeah, not, of course, yeah. In this time period, in this time control, you need to make something.
But now I attack the rook.
Yes, so rook needs to go somewhere. Maybe c4, Maybe c4. Okay, after g...
possible, no.
Okay, I will take c5 with knight. Yeah. So knight will take. Okay, generally white is better for sure, but still black will have some.
F7 is possible.
Also, yeah, you're right. This is a good move.
Yeah, probably now is attacking the bishop and the pawn.
Yeah. So you need to go.
Maybe not f8, but this is also hanging. Everything is hanging.
Only one move here, and just simply take on g7 and finish.
Yes, maybe white is clearly better now.
Yeah.
Maybe. I'm not sure. What do you think?
Yeah, sure.
Because this rook here on g4, I mean, doesn't look very nice.
Yeah, she looks like active, but. Simply now she is not nothing the
What if I go back, for example? I don't like it, but I go back this.
Yeah, possibly. So we take on
I
a
just
h5.
Give the pawn, but the queen for a while stands on here. That's why I'm thinking if I can take some, I mean,
yeah, you have some
advantage of this.
Practically time you have some.
If I attack, for example, now knight takes
take.
Maybe some attacking chances.
Yeah. Okay, you have now, you need to take on c5, because in...
If I take with the bishop, maybe knight g5. That's why I prefer to take on with the queen. And also, I attack the g3 pawn, maybe king g2, for
yes,
example.
Simply
you cannot take because there is this move, rook
yeah.
c1. And now what? How can I now continue? I don't see how. Maybe d4.
D4, yeah.
Maybe
more active.
Is it okay? Maybe.
D4, rook, maybe rook somewhere. Or maybe. Okay, this move is not possible. I think about c3, but c3, d3, yeah. So we
yeah.
need to stay. Yeah. I want to open the c file, but it's not possible.
Yeah. Well, some active game play, but with right play, I think white is better, you know?
Yeah.
But black should play like this, I think. Okay, let's see what he will do. He played something. What he played? He took on c5.
On c5 with the bishop.
Yes, bishop now attacking g3 pawn and king g2.
Yes, simply.
Now again, probably he needs one more active move, but I don't know what. Two games finished. Oh.
Okay, four games is finished. I see that Batu Angun win.
Batu Angun wins.
Yeah, so we have one
so
draw.
So fast. How come?
It's yeah, we have one
so
draw
fast.
On board 10. So Hulka Ahmed Uktu. And we have Shpanko Nadia is win with Etzeos Bay.
Uh-huh. Also finished, huh?
Also finished. So now it's
Ejeyevbay lost, yes?
Yes. So 2.5, 1.5 for Ukraine.
And who has won in Ukraine? You said
Shpanko and Plucha, board number 8.
Number 8. Uh-huh. So against Emirhan Tarlabaşı.
Okay, step by
so
step.
Fast,
we can move to the next game, port number
this
3.
This one is, let's see how he lost.
Okay,
so
Yurovsky,
far.
Yeah, what was happened? It was Sicilian, I think.
Yes.
G5.
Pierce defense, I think.
Pierce,
yes.
It
transposes to some kind of King's Indian, yes.
Yes, Trompovsky
yes.
and Pierce,
yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yes.
Structure is...
Yeah.
So like Sicilian in some variation.
Yes.
Okay, g5. Black have a good position because they have a e5 square.
Yes. Uh-huh. g4.
Oh. But okay, it's...
Knight h4, he didn't want to. I don't know why.
No, yeah, maybe it's possible to go and after to go f5, maybe.
Yeah,
to...
sure. Also, on h4, I don't see what's wrong with going to h4. Anyway, knight e5, e3. Uh-huh, he cannot take, and knight d3 is a little bit disturbing. Okay, gb3, takes, and knight d3,
anyway. Black goes to d3, so you
yes.
need, okay,
sure.
Maybe you don't need to take on e6.
Yes,
maybe
exactly.
Maybe c3, yeah, in this
yeah,
moment.
Yes, why you take, you're right. This is also probably a mistake. Because he activates the rook.
Yeah. And now, yes. Ah,
yeah.
It's a concrete, yeah.
Oh,
so,
blunder.
So he blunder a piece, yeah. So he take on g4
one
and lose the knight.
But I don't understand, Sasha. They have 8 minutes on their clock. And why do they play so fast?
Yeah, because probably I think that mostly of them, they play... especially bullet and blitz games. So, you know, this is like...
This is the
Yeah, of course.
This is the actual problem.
Yeah, it's a problem with all juniors to transfer from another controls. Yeah, so they need to move for a normal game. So that's why the idea was to give a possibility to play with normal chess. Let's say rapid is okay, because for blitz and bullet it happens a lot of mistakes. So
yes.
Okay.
But actually, on the second board, there have been an interesting sacrifice.
Look. Wow. So
knight f6. Very interesting sacrifice. Actually, two-piece sacrifice. He takes and another sacrifice.
Uh-huh.
Now he wants to take on g3.
On g3, so...
He's mating. Let's see.
Yeah.
Let's see if I take what's going on here.
Okay, queen takes.
King somewhere.
Okay, maybe, okay, so you have check on e4. And you can simply take on f3. Okay, probably white will not survive here. But who knows? Okay, if you take on f3, just...
Maybe first check here also.
Maybe check here, because I want to give check.
But I can go here, no?
c1. Just you need to take on f3.
But if I take here, what's going on?
Simply rook... No.
You take here, yes.
No, maybe it's not good. Maybe simply rook d1. You need to protect. You just go to rook
d1. If I take rook d1.
Yeah, rook d1, and after I go...
Because if you take d takes e4, it looks bad, yes.
Okay, white have extra piece, but it's...
Now maybe g takes f6 or
something. Yeah, it's too much pawns. Too much pawns and the...
activity. Very nice sacrifice.
Yeah, very interesting.
Can, he is very talented player. Turkish
youngest
international master. He became international master at the age of 13. And he is also working very hard. Also, you know what, Sasha? He is a very strong tennis player.
Ah, tennis. Table tennis.
Yes, he is usually champion of his age. Very strong.
So he's
he's doing both in chess and tennis together.
Wow.
Interesting, yes?
So next time we can organize in regular life, we can organize some, let's say, mix event with table tennis or...
Table tennis. My son also is playing tennis and table tennis. My son is also, like Işıkcan, he is a very good tennis player. He is 11 years old. But now the pandemic time, sometimes he cannot play. He is in depression. Depression times.
bad time for us, but what to do?
Especially when you make such kind of sports, if you are very young, you know, so difficult.
Yeah, you should be active day by day, yeah?
Yes. But fortunately, they are not allowed to go out, you know, in Turkey.
Yeah,
they
I know.
Allowed to go out.
Maybe only for tourists, maybe for foreigners, this rule is not obligation, but for locals.
In Ukraine, is it the same?
No, we have lockdown. It means that lockdown is everything is closed, only markets, but you can go everywhere in which time you prefer. So at night, restriction about this.
No restriction. But what about the cases? You know, how many people are getting sick? What about this?
For now, I think it's going lower. So I think it was maybe before New Year. It was too many cases, but now
the problem is that the hospitals are getting full, so this is
the problem. Yeah, the medicine is
cracked. So the position became like this. I don't understand how it became like this. Let's see.
He didn't take.
Knight
e5. Yeah. Knight e5. So he take on g3. It's not possible to take because I will take on f2. Yeah.
Yes.
Also rook is...
Yes. Good move, knight e5. Takes. And now takes.
So he win. We finished this game as I see on Tornello. So Kukelko
wins. This is finished.
Yeah, it's finished. We can see. Yeah, because we have some delay, let's say. So some of you.
What's the result?
1-0. Kukelko wins.
Wow. He wins this.
Yeah, we need to wait for
this sacrifice probably. Was dubious. Okay, let's move on.
Yeah.
Kukelko won. So you are winning probably the second part of the match, huh? Okay, let's go to the which one? Which game? Kayra Kamer, Semen Mitusov.
Yeah, sure. Board number okay. three.
Let's commentate on the last position, because if you look at the opening phase, it takes too much time. Let's look at the last position.
H5,
played by black.
Okay.
How many pawns? Four.
Okay, one extra for black, but seems it can be draw because
yes, it can be draw, yes, because of this double
because,
pawn.
We
yes.
have to white also can promote the pawn, so yes. when they exchange, so it good means draw-ish. Every pawns are in the one side, so okay, it's chances to make draw because of also double pawns. I mean, yes. black,
white also can activate the king probably. And also maybe from here you can go to attack the rook or something like this. Maybe the c pawn will go and then take on.
Yes.
They will exchange
just
the both pawns. And it looks like drawish position. Let's move on to the fifth board. No, the fourth
the
board.
But Bondar Alparslan.
Ah, okay. The fourth board is finished. Yes, but Angun, what happened?
Yes. So here we have extra piece for black, but still a lot of pawns.
Too many pawns, yes.
Too many pawns, yes. So probably white will survive for sure, because it's very hard to give him.
White is winning. What is this position?
No, white.
But black is too active, yes.
Yeah, too active because of rook, yeah. And simply we can go with another rook. Okay, if we exchange rooks, one pair of rooks, so it
last
will be
move
chance.
Is H5.
Yeah, some will. It will be some chance for white to win when we will exchange one pair of rook. If we have double rook, so it will be problems for white.
Maybe rook D2. But
okay,
not
rook,
check.
Rook F1, just check and go back.
Doesn't have anything. Black will be probably happy to make draw this position.
Yeah.
It's not some position very difficult to win. So it's difficult for black.
We can go to another game, board number six.
Board number six. Alexander Vakulenko.
Vakulenko playing with Omer Faruk.
Yes.
International master. I know him well also. Mostly of Turkish players I know personally, so I meet them.
You played also in Rodostosha.
Ah, yes, I remember this experience.
Yeah, remember.
Yes, I played with girls. It was such a kind of Turkish youth girls team. But it's completely, I have some
Slav was break. Playing that. It's
yes,
Slav.
I have some break for standard chess, so that's why I remember when I analyzed my games after, it was terrible. Yeah, a lot of blunders. But okay, it was anyway, it was good, well organized. It was good experience for them, for us, so... I remember this time. So here we have...
What is this position? Very complicated position.
Very complicated. I prefer black because they are more active.
Yeah, now threatening mate. Queen F3 check.
Yeah, simply mate in two, yeah?
Yeah.
So what to do? Nothing to do, because if you will go, for example, queen D1, so I just ten take on B5, yeah?
But there is one move I see. Queen C3.
Queen C3. Okay, yes, what to do now?
Now I don't lose the piece.
Okay, maybe I can go knight H3. Knight H3, it's interesting. After
maybe there is also one more move. Sasha, this move.
This
if
one
check,
just,
I can give he come
just
here.
To protect, yeah, okay, but after I can go rook g8. It's
yes, but now have to. I mean, it's overprotected here. And how do you continue the attack? Maybe I will try to exchange the queens or something like this. I don't know how. Can I?
Okay, it's not
queens
easy. Yeah.
Rook e1, maybe.
I'm aware of white position, so...
But black, of course, black is better, yes.
Of course, better. Best dynamic, most... And also, knight from d7 can comes here, from b6 to d5, e3, yeah, so...
Yeah.
more moves
what,
for.
What's going on here? He played bishop f1.
Yes. So he found
queen
this.
F3, check, rook g8, they played. Queen b3, they played. Queen g4. Rook e1, knight d5. Goes back the pieces.
Uh-huh.
He goes back with the pieces. Knight f4, actually, I will never play. But no. He couldn't find anything, probably.
Okay, you need to go with another knight. So the another knight.
Knight on d7, yes. Is not
so
working at all.
Black playing now without one piece. Yes, so you
yes,
need
exactly.
To make active this the second the last.
Probably white is getting better position slowly by slowly because his pawn up. Wait.
Oh, something changed.
Suddenly, okay. Dramatically changed position. The position is dramatically changed. He sacrificed the pawn and then activated the knight.
Okay.
Very nice, very nice. Yes,
I want to
nice.
Go to f3, yeah?
Yes, very nice actually sacrifice. But maybe still I don't see how you made me.
Okay, well, it can be easy just in like a blitz player. So simply takes on e5 and go c6, yeah? Just
yes.
Make a move by hand. Yeah?
You want to sacrifice.
Yeah, sacrifice. Maybe it's enough.
And push the pawn.
Push the pawn. Maybe after I have also
good,
f6.
Good idea. Very strong, fast pawn. Actually, this looks
if
like...
If you don't give me a mate in few moves...
He didn't want to. He just went to queen e4.
So he go to defense. This is
but
not...
But now nice. This knight is very strong still. Knight can go to g4, to d3. And now... Some problems again.
Yeah, you need to go rook d1 to protect d3 square.
D1, okay.
And after to push the pawn, c6 and okay. And
yeah,
after
if the attack doesn't go, I mean, with the force, looks like white is winning.
It's not, I don't see any tactic.
And you don't see any force mate or something, so probably black is worse now.
Yeah, because of pawns. Yeah, so we have three pawns.
Yeah.
We have passed
so
pawns.
Black is probably losing. Okay, now Ukraine is getting.
Let's move to. Can check Samonenkov game, board number 7. With the king Barisho Zenir.
Okay, what's this position? 6 pawns against 6 pawns, but
okay,
there is a d6 pawn.
Okay, so
which
it's
is weak or strong, I'm not sure.
Okay, it's easy win for white. It's easy
e5
win for
maybe.
White, so you just simply go. Oh, maybe not. Yeah, you have e5.
Uh-huh.
It's not possible to come
but,
with.
But there is the continuation. Bishop here.
And bishop
now bishop here, but I can come now.
No, no, you can simply take on b3, yeah?
Ah, you take on b3.
Uh-huh. So probably it's...
Maybe, okay. Maybe losing.
Maybe losing for white, yeah, because here knight is better, yeah. You have a lot of squares, you have c5, yeah. d4, and you now you have a pass pawn on b4.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right.
So it's
maybe
changed.
This one is good for Turkish young player Ekim Barış Özenir, this position. Okay, let's move to the 8th board. Mihailo Yuka against Emir Hal. He won, you told me. He won, yes?
Yes.
Yuka won. Okay.
Luka won and number 9 also Rostislav Malinovsky win. With Orduna
this is finished. Huh? Okay, probably the king's ending lost.
Yes.
He will lose the f4.
Same thing,
yes. So this is also Orkun lost. Okay, so you are already leading how many, I mean, too much difference, yes?
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And
six already, yeah?
6 already with 2 draws, so it means 7. 7-3.
So it's already half points
plus
you
four.
Are winning.
Plus 4, yeah?
7-3, so it's plus 4, yes. Maria Bertzik
in the progress for games we have. So board number 1. So let's move to board number 1,
let's check the girls. We don't check the girls.
Yeah, sure. This is
Bertzik actually she made draw against Musenas Kocit. This is the last position. What happened here? Okay, this is repetition.
Repetition, yeah.
Repetition, and who is better here?
Find the possibility to attack more, yeah. Because not a lot of pieces can attack from black side.
And dangerous position.
The dangerous for black if they don't find the move.
Yes. So,
B pawn will promote in a few moves.
Exactly. Also, the knight is hanging.
Yeah. So you need to give check, and mate.
Yeah.
Repetition. Yeah. So it's automatically. Basically, on Tornello, we have a settings now. It's very simple for arbiters and very very good for players because in Tornello you can adjust the settings that free time, repetition, and 50 moves immediately finish the draw without claiming. Yeah,
like let's check. Ece Özbay lost. Yes, you said Ece Özbay lost.
Yes.
Gülenay, let's check Gülenay Aydın what she did.
So she win. Gulenai win against
Kripinchikova,
board number 13, and also this
she won this game.
It's finished. Ihor Simonenko lose again against King Boris Ozdemir. This you remember this ending bishop against knight.
Boris Ozdemir, he won this. Yes.
He won this game. So we have three games in the progress. So still playing board number one, Sidorica NS Tanriverdi. Board number three, Mitusov Kaira Kamer. And board number six, Vakulenko Omer Faruk Ozer.
Okay, number one is this is the position.
Okay.
The last move, bishop d3. So,
totally draw. Yeah, no chance for white.
Yes, looks like black survived this. Yes,
it's like some castle. Yeah, so you have some tower, let's say. So it's protected.
Fortress, yes.
Fortress. Yeah. This I mean. Bishop,
now is it a fortress?
Yeah, for sure. Who knows when I with the okay? I can go.
This is not for sure now.
It's not for sure, because the
if
pawns,
I go to f5 and
go to d7 with
I can sacrifice the bishop, this
f4 you have a possibility,
now this is not so easy after exchanging the queens.
Okay, pawns I think is winning,
of
if you will go f4
this is a win maybe for white
because after I will go to take on h4.
Yes, this looks like losing for black. So what else do we have? Kamer is playing. Kamer.
Wow.
Okay.
What is it? Okay, they change. Okay. So the pawn and on a3 survive. So black takes somehow put pawn on c5. As you remember this end game. Okay.
Yes. This
still
ending
still
was
chances
like...
for black. Yes, yeah, still chances. Practically.
Yes. Some chances, you're right. And this pawn on h4 also, this is also weak.
Yeah, only possibility to make a draw to take on h5 and come back to a5 and protect a line,
You have to take on h5, yes, you're right.
Yeah, take and maybe you have some chances to go with h4. Yeah, h4, h5, but...
Yes. Why he didn't want to take now?
Okay, we can see a2.
A2, rook here.
And maybe
bishop e5 probably.
Yeah, bishop e5 winning.
Very simply winning, yes.
Yeah.
So he cannot play this king here, but now I cannot play this because of bishop d4, maybe. Yes. I don't want to allow you to play bishop e5. Can I attack the bishop or
what to do now? Okay, e5, it's nothing. Nothing, a5. Maybe e5, e4, e3. But okay, it's...
Let's see, this looks actually losing, huh?
Yeah, losing for sure.
Looks very bad, actually.
Okay,
this a2 pawn is very strong.
Yeah, so simply you can go e4, e3, I think.
Yes,
it's enough.
Right.
So you need to go queen.
If I go here, there is this move, and then giving check, and then a1, or maybe no. Wait a minute.
No. Wait. Because bishop d4 we have. Okay, maybe. So you need to go with
not
the.
Not so easy, maybe.
Yeah, just simply go to the king to d7 e6.
Maybe after e5, let's not push this.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, maybe we can go to.
Because now you give this freedom to bishop.
Yeah, this line. Yeah. So king d7, king e6.
FD, let's say here. Now where to go with the bishop? The problem is the bishop.
A1.
Now maybe the king comes.
Yeah, maybe.
Because now I want to play maybe bishop c5 or something, or maybe
yeah, king bishop c5 and bishop d4. Yeah. Maybe.
Yes.
Maybe yes. I don't know. It's need to calculate because it's rare complicated. Yes. Yeah? So you need to find a way.
But after bishop c5, maybe you can take on e5. So this is not so easy.
Yeah, right? I agree. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. This looks winning actually, but he won.
He won, yes.
Yeah, so, he played. How did he play? Okay, king e3. This.
So we finish. We finish the match.
Match finished.
Yeah, match finished. So I will check from chess result. It's 8.5 and 5.5. So plus 3.
Okay, 8.5 against 5.5. Ukraine won. Congratulations, Sasha.
Thank you. It was, as I mentioned before, it was a just friendly match. Of course, it more than official, but we're trying to give a chance for juniors to meet and play. So as I say, the result is not important. Important is our meeting, our friendship for future, our contacts.
Yes, actually, thank you for this idea of this friendship match, friendly match, because it's actually very nice that two country are getting closer, and we know that Ukraine is a very strong chess country, very strong chess country. Actually, Ivanchuk is one of my favorites, you know. He is one of my favorites. I love him very much. I think we finished this transmission today. The first part of the transmission was in Turkish. We couldn't do together, but now the second part, we did it together. I want to thank you for the organization of the match, for your participation in the commentary. I hope in the next, probably, friendly matches or other organizations will be together, maybe. What do you think?
Yeah. We should take more possibilities. So maybe we can organize rematch or some other, let's say, tournament or match. Maybe some young
players. Maybe there can be some friendly match with the national team.
National team also possible to
take. Yes,
it will be also interesting to promote Turkish and Ukrainian.
Or maybe some one-by-one matches. You know, Mustafa, for example, Wahab, they can play with some very strong players of Ukraine. What do you think?
Yeah. So we can think about this. So nice idea. And I believe in 2021. Surely we organize something. Maybe you remember a few days ago, before this match, we organized some, let's say it was also friendly school event, it was just for four countries. So Azerbaijan, Turkey, Georgia and Ukraine participate. It was such kind of mix event. We organized this together with my friends from Azerbaijan, Turkey and Georgia, and was only chess. Also, there is information on Turkish Chess Federation webpage, so also you can find this. It was just friendly event with Blitz, and we have 24 players in total in one team. So it means under 7, under 9, so it means like World Score event. Yeah, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17. It was also very good. And I hope that the games will be appear on Megabase and Tweak, and also you can see these games after.
Okay. Before we finish this transmission, I want to give you the results of two matches. On the first match, Turkey played with white pieces. and they have beaten Ukraine with 7.5, with 6 and against 6.5 with a 1-point margin. But on the second part of this match, Ukraine has beaten Turkey. What's the score? 8.5 versus 5.5 with a 3-points margin. Overall, the score is 15 points for Ukraine and 13 points for Turkey. But the match ended 1-1, of course. The result, overall result, is in favor of Ukraine. We congratulate both teams for their actually play, both, all the players who participated in this event and all the organizers who worked for this event to happen, and also the Turkish Chess Federation for this live comment, organization of this live transmission. So thank you, Sasha.
Thank you so much. Çok teşekkür ederim.
Thank you
so much
for the invitation,
for your, for your work, for your job. It was nice to see you.
Thank
so
you. Nice
to meet you this year in real life.
Yes, I hope so too. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, dear guests, we finish our live transmission. Thank you for watching us. I wish we can be together in the other commentaries. See you next time. Bye-bye.